Check.
Hello, everybody. Good evening. If we could have a seat, we'll get started in about 2 minutes. Thank you. Good evening and welcome to Conard High School's Senior Awards Night. I'm Julia Duarte, the principal of Conard High School. At this time, I would ask that you please rise for the singing of the national anthem performed by several of our very talented solo choir members. How about another round of applause for our amazing vocalists? Tonight, we have the opportunity to honor over 140 students. But before we do, I would like to take a moment and thank all of our parents, caregivers, and everyone else at home watching. A night like this is certainly intended to acknowledge the hard work of our students, but we all know that their achievement is not an individual accomplishment. Each person being honored tonight has a support system of family, friends, teachers and coaches, and the list goes on and on. I want to thank you for your unwavering support and encourage our recipients to do the same at some point this week. I also want to sincerely thank all of the various donors. Without your generous donation, tonight would not be possible. We are aware that several students are not able to be here today, but we'll still read their names and the award description because we firmly believe that they deserve to be honored. The West Hartford Public Schools vision of the graduate is composed of several attitudes and dispositions that we want to ensure all students demonstrate before they graduate. One of these is perseverance. As human beings, we all thrive on being successful, but we often forget the difficulties that we encountered on our path to success. Too often, we set targets and want to achieve them immediately, but that is not how life works. Here is where perseverance comes into play. The doing something despite difficulty or delay in achieving success. Perhaps the best part of perseverance is you do not need any special talent or privilege to access it. Instead, you simply need a strong will and to never quit. So as you move forward through life, please remember that regardless of your goal, or even how long it may take you to achieve that goal, the key to your success depends largely on your willingness to persevere. When asked if he enjoyed training for his upcoming fights, the great Muhammad Ali replied, "I hated every minute of training, but I said to myself, don't quit. Suffer now, and the rest of your life, you will be a champion." Congratulations. All of you have clearly demonstrated perseverance as you have worked hard to achieve high levels of success here at Conard. I am confident that if you continue to do so throughout the rest of your endeavors, you will continue to find great success. Now, to present tonight's awards are assistant principals, Ms. Tringali, Mr. Fisk, and Mr. Hines.
Good evening, everyone. Our first award, congratulations to Gabriella Zaloff, this year's recipient of the American Association of Teachers of French Outstanding Senior Medal, which is given to an outstanding student of French.
Sorry, I forgot to tell you guys, when you hear your name, just come right up and then you can come across the stage. Thank you.
It's tough to read this. Congratulations. Congratulations to Luke Yanisi, this year's recipient of the American Association of Teachers of Spanish and Portuguese Literature Award, which is given to an outstanding student of Spanish literature. Congratulations to Allison Pauliuk, this year's recipient of the American Classical League Award, which is awarded to a senior who shows a commitment to learning and achievement in advanced Latin or ancient Greek. Congratulations to Mara Cicchetti and Charles Kreisch, this year's recipients of the American Legion and American Legion Auxiliary Distinguished Achievement School Award, which is given to two seniors who display high scholarship and citizenship. Congratulations to Tejal Nair and Rashiel Yarabelli, this year's Conard High School winners by virtue of their score on the American math competition, The AMC 12 is a 25-question, 75-minute multiple-choice examination in high school mathematics designed to promote the development and enhancement of problem-solving skills. The exam challenges students and offers problem-solving experiences beyond those provided in most upper-level high school mathematics classes. Congratulations to Mara Cicchetti and Nora Wilson, this year's recipients of the American Psychological Association Book Award, which is given to seniors who demonstrate hard work, dedication, and extensive interest in the field of psychology. Congratulations to Lucy Buccilli, this year's recipient of the Art Department Award, which is given to an outstanding senior who shows all-around performance in art. Congratulations to Isabel Burnett Herkes and Juliet Pia, this year's recipients of the Band Jazz Band PTO Award, which is given to students who demonstrate strong leadership skills, dedication to music making, and a positive presence in and out of the classroom. Congratulations to Austin Crossley and Jessica McNally, this year's recipients of the Business Education PTO Award, which is given to outstanding students based on all-around performance in business education. Congratulations to Brendan Hill and Ariana Sarwar, this year's recipients of the Careers in Foods PTO Award, which is given to students who demonstrate a serious interest in pursuing a degree in the culinary arts or a related field, possess a high degree of knowledge and skills in the culinary arts, and have consistently demonstrated leadership in the classroom by participating in many school and community catering projects. Congratulations to Tolu Adetola, this year's recipient of the Jeffrey Karples Memorial Award. Jeffrey Karples, a 1969 graduate of Conard, was student government president at both Conard and Princeton University, and went on to hold managerial positions with the Office of the Mayor of New York and Columbia University. This award, in his honor, goes to a senior who has distinguished himself in student government. Congratulations to Emma Alford, this year's recipient of the Mike Carr Sportsmanship Award. Michael Carr, Conard class of 1973, was a talented athlete whose legacy lies in the spirit of sportsmanship he demonstrated so vividly both on and off the field. This award, in his honor, goes to an outstanding senior who exhibits sportsmanship qualities during his or her sports season. Congratulations to Xavier Benitez and Vivian Nguyen, this year's recipient of the Child Development PTO Award, which is given to outstanding students based on all-around performance in child development. Congratulations to Kieran Davis and Olivia Socal, and they are this year's recipients of the Choral Music PTO Award, which is given to students who demonstrate strong leadership skills, dedication to music making, and a positive presence in and out of the classroom. Congratulations to Nina DeVries, this year's recipient of the Tyler Claflin Memorial Orchestra Award. Navy Lieutenant Tyler Claflin, MD, Conard class of 2002, was one of Conard's finest. He was known to arrive to orchestra with boundless enthusiasm for making music with his cello. Tyler approached every class, lesson, early morning rehearsal, concert, and music trips filled with joy and expectation. He was a wonderful and accomplished young man and will never be forgotten by those who knew him. This memorial award goes to a Conard senior in the orchestra who best exemplifies the spirit of Tyler Claflin. Congratulations to Nora Wilson, this year's recipient of the Classical Studies Award, which is awarded to an advanced Latin or ancient Greek student who demonstrates a commitment to academic pursuits and an enthusiasm for ancient Roman and Greek culture. Congratulations to Benjamin Covici, this year's recipient of the Marion F. and Norman Cohen Memorial Scholarship. Marion Cohen worked as the Conard Guidance Office Secretary for over 15 years, where her smiling face and willingness to go out of her way to help students and staff was greatly appreciated. She and her husband, Norman Cohen, placed great emphasis on the value of education. They valued the importance of achievement within the classroom and also finding time to pursue passions, whether in music, community service, or sports. Marion and Norman Cohen passed along these values to their own children. Mrs. Cohen also brought these values to her work, where she was dedicated to helping Conard students pursue their educational goals. This scholarship, sponsored by the Cohens' three children, honors their memory and goes to a senior who has demonstrated achievement in their academic and extracurricular pursuits in the areas of music, service to the community, or athletics, and who plan to continue to fulfill her or his educational goals after high school. Congratulations to Ariana Fandozzi, Katrina Jenka, Chloe Scrimger, and Rushiel Yarabelli, this year's recipient of the Conard High School Spirit Award, which is awarded to seniors who demonstrate the core values, beliefs, and spirit of the Conard High School community. This award is made possible by donations from the class of 1996 in memory of classmates Liam Snow, Brienne Francisco, Tara Jean Molshan, and Sylvie Potashner. Congratulations to Xavier Benitez, this year's recipient of the Conard Retirees Award, which is given to a senior who has shown the greatest academic and/or citizenship improvement. Congratulations to Emma Kramer, Allison Pelyuk, and Juliet Pia, selected as this year's Connecticut All-State Music Festival representatives. The Connecticut All-State Music Festival selects the top musicians in the state based on statewide auditions. These students are recognized for their participation in the festival. Congratulations to Stephanie Runing Shearer and Nora Wilson, this year's recipients of the Connecticut High School Arts Award, which is given to two seniors who demonstrate outstanding ability in the performing and visual arts, scholarship, and leadership. Congratulations to Rose McGowan and Nicholas Urso, this year's recipients of the Connecticut High School Scholar Athlete Award, which is given to one female and one male senior who excel academically, are a varsity letter winner, and have demonstrated exemplary citizenship and leadership. Congratulations to Eileen Chen, this year's recipient of the Creative Process Award, which is given to a senior who has done the most for the school community through their commitment and achievement in the visual arts. Congratulations to Kara Maloney, this year's recipient of the Frederick A. DeLuca Foundation Award. The foundation was established by Fred DeLuca, president of the Subway restaurant chain, to help schools and charitable organizations give others a chance to help themselves. This award goes to a senior with academic achievement and involvement in extracurricular activities who will be attending an accredited college or university and who was employed while attending high school. Congratulations to Lillian Gallinato, Madeline Levesque, James McPhee, Tyler Remigino, and Jamie Sterling, this year's recipients of the Department Supervisors Award, which is given to seniors with high academic achievement across all disciplines. Congratulations to Kieran Davis and Stephanie Runing-Shearer, this year's recipients of the Drama Department Acting PTO Award, which is given to two seniors who have demonstrated talent and commitment on the stage in theatrical productions. Congratulations to Nora Wilson, this year's recipient of the Drama Department Technical Theater PTO Award, which is given to a senior who has demonstrated talent and commitment behind the scenes of theatrical productions. Congratulations to Patrick Hemingway, this year's recipient of the Michael Dubay Memorial Award. Michael Dubay, a Conard class of 1988 graduate, was swim team captain, an active member of student council, and admired by peers and staff for his good nature and good spirit. This award in his honor goes to a male senior who is good-natured, involved in student government, a member of an athletic team, and who exhibits positive school spirit. Congratulations to Skylin Macy, this year's recipient of the English Department Creative Writing Award, which is given to a senior who demonstrates outstanding ability in creative writing, evidenced by school, state, and/or national recognition. Congratulations to Chandani Krishna Prasad, this year's recipient of the English Department PTO Award, which is given to a senior who has shown excellence in performance. Congratulations to V. Kong Lee and Angel Matthew, this year's recipients of the English as a Second Language PTO Award, which is given to outstanding students based on all-around performance in English as a second language. Congratulations to Sandy Lee, this year's recipient of the Excellence in Chinese Language Award, which is given to a Chinese language student who demonstrates excellence in all elements of language learning and is a true role model in the classroom. Congratulations to Jet Rosner, this year's recipient of the Exchange Club Youth of the Year Award, which is given to a senior who displays superior qualities of leadership, scholarship, athletic ability, industry, and a demonstrated commitment of service to high school or community. Congratulations to Xavier Benitez, Randy Figueroa Acevedo, Hanif Jackson, Jasmine Maldonado, Jonathan Rivera, Kylie Spillane, Aman Thapa, this year's recipients of the Faculty Scholarship Award, or Dress Down Award for a senior, which is given to seniors who have made significant improvements socially and or academically during their time here at Conard, and who is continuing their education at an accredited institution of higher learning. C- Congratulations to Ian Nicastro, this year's recipient of the Kira M. Fisher Memorial Arts Award. Kira M. Fisher, 1981 to 2002, Conard class of 1999, was a talented artist pursuing a career in filmmaking. She was also an excellent student and a person who had profound influence on the people who knew her. This award, which her family hopes will continue that influence by enabling other artists to achieve their dreams, goes to a unique senior who has a passion for art and plans to major in or pursue a career in visual art. Now please welcome our athletic director, Jason Siegel, to present this evening's athletic awards.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jason Siegel. I am the Director of Athletics for the West Hartford Public Schools, and I have the privilege to name this year's recipients of our Senior Athletic Awards. I'd like to extend my congratulations to all the recipients so far this evening. Just a simply amazing group, amazing senior class. To our student athletes, as you've heard Mr. Duarte say earlier, you have persevered through a very, very different way of playing high school sports this year. From not knowing if you would even have a season, to adjusting to new rules, to knowing your team could have been quarantined at any moment, and to finally playing and not know if your season would end prematurely. I could not be more proud of the positive attitude you maintained all year long. The Conard and West Hartford community are proud of you and wish you the very best of luck in your future endeavors. And onto the awards for this evening. First, I'd like to offer congratulations to Bridget Drummy and Connor Alekna, recipients of the Distinguished Athlete Award. This award is awarded to the senior student athlete who participates in a varsity sport, is an exemplary young citizen and role model for younger student athletes, and best exhibits the personal traits of courage, poise, self-confidence, and leadership. Next, I'd like to congratulate Avery Policita and Dominic Bavaro, recipients of this year's Dale Harper Award. This is awarded to the senior student athlete who exemplifies the highest standards of sportsmanship, both on and off the field. Next, I'd like to congratulate the following seniors: Emma Alford, Sarah Burnett, Maggie Leonard, and Gabriella Sohn, this year's recipients of the Norm Johnson Managers Award. This is awarded to a student who assisted the coach in the many daily tasks of the team. Congratulations. Next, I'd like to congratulate Savannah Paulito and Allie Shane, this year's recipients of the Justine Clark Award. This is awarded to a young lady whose sensitivity to others and willingness to sacrifice for the team exemplify her total dedication to her team and Conard's athletic program. Next, I'd like to congratulate Colette Haverty, this year's recipient of the Title IX Award. This is awarded to a female student athlete who possesses outstanding skill and ability and who demonstrates the highest standards of sportsmanship, cooperation, and leadership in her commitment to Conard sports. Next, I'd like to congratulate Josh Sermon.
Josh is the recipient of the Coach Frank Dinolfo Athletic Award, which is awarded to a male multi-sport student athlete who exemplifies the essence of teamwork and good sportsmanship through his unselfish contributions to his team, his dedication, perseverance, positive attitude, patience, and work ethic, and ultimately reflects the spirit and pride of Conard Athletics. Next, I'd like to congratulate Maeve Darcy and Owen McGoldrick, this year's recipients of the Chuck Landrosh Award. This is awarded to a female and male senior athlete who demonstrates the qualities of respect, commitment, team spirit, leadership, and outstanding academic achievement. Next, I'd like to congratulate the following senior student athletes: Madeline Jakubowski, Ava Johnson, Molly Gorman, Shay McCann, Chloe Scrimger, Xavier Benitez, Tyler Remigino, Ryan Roller, Benjamin Roach, and Evan Smart as this year's recipients of the Pride Award. This is awarded to the student athletes who have exemplified themselves as a student, as an athlete, a spectator, and as a citizen to the Conard tradition. Congratulations. Next, I'd like to congratulate Rose McGowan and Rowan Sierra as this year's recipients of the Lance Corporal Lawrence R. Philippon Memorial Award. This is awarded to a senior athlete who shows genuine respect for others, demonstrates dedication to their team, and shows respect to the flag, for the Pledge of Allegiance, and to those who serve our country. To be eligible for this award, candidates had to submit an essay that answers the following questions. What do the words of the Pledge of Allegiance mean to you, and what does being an American mean to you? All submitted essays are read and chosen by Lisa and Ray Philippon, Larry's parents. Congratulations. The next, I would like to congratulate Andrew Riker, this year's recipients of the Coach Bob McKee Award. This is given to a senior football player who embodies the characteristics of what our first head coach, Bob McKee, would describe as a true chieftain football player: discipline, character, commitment, leadership, and grit. And lastly, I'd like to congratulate Nick Urso, this year's recipient of the Jim Spignesi Award. This is awarded to a member of the boys lacrosse team who demonstrates the qualities of commitment and dedication as a leader and team player. Congratulations, Nick. Congratulations again to all of tonight's recipients. And at this time, I'd like to welcome Assistant Principal Tor Fisk to the stage to continue tonight's program.
Congratulations to Jordan Cherry, this year's recipient of the Foundation for West Hartford Public Schools Equity Advancement Award. It is the mission of the Foundation for West Hartford Public Schools, FWHPS, to support educational projects, programs, and initiatives that enhance and enliven the classroom experience for all West Hartford Public School students. This mission can be best fulfilled when our schools and our community are equitable and inclusive. The FWHP Equity Advancement Award will be presented to one graduating senior from Conard High School and one graduating senior from Hall High School, who have each demonstrated a commitment to realizing racial justice, inclusion, and anti-discrimination in our community. Congratulations to Rowan Sierra, this year's recipient of the Paul J. Haggerty Memorial Award. Paul Joseph Haggerty was born and raised in West Hartford. He was number 7 out of a family of 8. As a young boy, Paul excelled in football, baseball, and hockey. Paul graduated from Conard High School in 1987, where he played hockey and was part of the 1986 state championship team. Hockey remained an important part of Paul's life as he went on to play Division I hockey at the United States Military Academy. His college hockey career culminated with Paul winning Army's Most Valuable Player in 1991. After retiring from the Army, Paul began his coaching career as an assistant coach to John Dunham at Trinity College. He spent the last 2 years of his life as an assistant coach to Rob Riley at the United States Military Academy. Paul died suddenly and unexpectedly while training with the hockey team on April 13, 1998, at the age of 29. His family that he left behind included sons Nick and Luke, who were ages 3 and 1 at the time of their dad's death. Paul was an exemplary man who was admired by all for his integrity, strong work ethic, commitment, kindness, and big heart. This award, given in his honor, goes to a senior who has embodied these qualities throughout their 4 years at Conard High School. Congratulations to Julia Race, this year's recipient of the Jennifer R. Hamilton Graphics Arts Scholarship Award. Jennifer Hamilton, a member of the Conard class of 2005, had hoped to pursue a graphic arts major in college. While at Conard, she participated in athletics, student government, and community service activities. Jenny's independent spirit and genuine attitude of caring, friendship, and loyalty has left a profound legacy within the Conard community. This award, established in her honor, goes to a senior planning to pursue a college education with a demonstrated talent and interest in the field of graphic arts who has made a positive contribution to the school and community. Congratulations to Rushil Yerevelli, this year's recipient of the Rosina Haskins Spirit of Community Award. This award, established by the faculty and staff of Conard High School, is in grateful appreciation of the contributions made to the school and community by Rosina Haskins during her time at Conard. This award, in her honor, goes to a senior who has demonstrated outstanding commitment to philanthropy through community service and volunteerism, and who has made a significant and positive difference in service to equity in school, community, and in the lives of others. Congratulations to Josh Spadabo, this year's recipient of the Health Careers PTO Award. Given to an outstanding junior or senior in the Health Careers program who has shown interest in pursuing a career in the healthcare field. Congratulations to Charles Christofak, this year's recipient of the Heart and Soul Award. This award, established with appreciation by Conard faculty and staff, recognizes the many contributions made to our school community by retired custodian Roy Karen. The recipient of this award is someone who demonstrates kindness towards others and contributes to the Conard community in meaningful ways, both large and small. The awardee is someone who appreciates and embraces alternative perspectives, both academically and socially. This person seeks to learn more about life each day. The recipient of the Heart and Soul Award is a person who acts as the glue of a classroom, team, or organization, someone who embraces collaboration with anyone and truly appreciates the opportunity to be a part of the school community each and every day. Congratulations to Nina Kluskovich, this year's recipient of the Jennifer Hodges Memorial Fund Scholarship. Jennifer Hodges, who graduated from Conard in 1977, was bright, highly motivated, and hardworking. Her positive energy was surpassed only by her ever-present smile. A respected student athlete, she captained both the cross-country and track teams in her senior year. Passionate about her nursing career, she was among the very first to be selected as a member of the specially trained Hartford LifeStar helicopter team, where she served as a flight nurse. Tragically, in June of 1992, the LifeStar helicopter crashed as it attempted to land at an accident scene. Jenny, the assistant chief flight nurse, was killed at age 32. This award, in her honor, goes to a senior who is planning to pursue a career in nursing. Congratulations to Isabella Ricciardi and Matthew Schatz, this year's recipients of the Jerry's Artorama Art Award, given to art students who have shown a commitment to the fine arts. Congratulations to Natalie Dela Cruz, this year's recipient of the Samuel Leonard Joseph Memorial Scholarship Award. Sam Joseph was a West Hartford student who attended Bugby, Bristow, and Sedgwick, who sadly took his life in 2008, just shy of finishing eighth grade. Sam is remembered for his engaging personality, bright smile, and can-do attitude. Sam's sisters, Michelle and Natalie Joseph, both Conard graduates, and his best friend, Adam Lefkowitz, work with the Hartford Foundation for Public Giving to administer a scholarship fund that will help teenagers from Conard or Hall or both schools with their future aspirations. This year's award is going to a senior from Conard who has post-high school education plans. This awardee has demonstrated impressive academic progress, commitment to her school and community, and that when she sets her mind to her goals, there is no stopping her. We wish her the best of luck and success in the next phase of her education. Congratulations to Victor Rojas, this year's recipient of the Lieutenant Colonel U.S. Army Retired Harold Hal Kevorkian Award. Lieutenant Colonel Hal Kevorkian retired from the U.S. Army Military Police Corps after 25 years of service, worked as a security officer at Conard High School for 18 years. In 2012, he completed 50 years of work in public safety, firefighting, police work, and emergency medical services as an EMT. During his years at Conard, LTC Kevorkian was dedicated to the safety of students and staff and always had a welcoming word for anyone entering the doors of Conard High. This award, in his honor, goes to a senior who plans to enter a branch of the military upon graduation or pursue a career in public safety, law enforcement, or criminal justice, is good-natured, friendly, and demonstrates a genuine concern for others. Congratulations to Eleanor Kahn, this year's recipient of the Kleiman O'Toole Award. Harry Kleiman served as chair of the West Hartford Democratic Town Committee for several years and was involved in local politics for over 40 years. He and his wife, Ruth, were very involved in many community activities. Braith Mara O'Toole was a former Democratic Town Committee chairman and an activist for peace. Additionally, she served her community through her work as a nurse. She was a very giving person who often took people experiencing difficulties into her own home. This award, in their honor and sponsored by the West Hartford Democratic Town Committee, goes to a senior who has shown outstanding academic achievement and community service. Congratulations to Barbara Leonard, this year's recipient of the Ray Lachat Memorial Award. Ray Lachat was a popular mathematics teacher at Conard who always tried to bring out the best in his students. This award, in his honor, goes to a senior who demonstrates a strong desire to learn, has achieved academically to her his capabilities, has post-secondary education goals that he intends to pursue in the next academic year, and has a reputation for friendliness and hard work, and has demonstrated sensitivity for the rights and feelings of others. Congratulations to Madeline Jakubowski, this year's recipient of the Chuck Landros PTO Award. Chuck Landros was was the principal at Conard from 1998 through 2007. Mr. Landroche was a strong advocate for all students, believing that each and every one can be successful. He was a role model for all in his demonstration of perseverance, dedication, and discipline. Mr. Landroche was also known for being a regular presence at school activities so that he could see students for more than their academic achievements. This award goes to a senior who has a reputation for the same kind of friendliness and hard work Mr. Landroche demonstrated on a daily basis, has achieved academically to his or her capabilities, and has made a positive contribution to Conard and the community. Congratulations to Stephanie Matos and Catherine Theory, this year's recipients of the Priscilla Lane Nursing Scholarship. Priscilla Denton Lane was an active member of the West Hartford community, where she and her husband Bruce raised three children, who are all Conard graduates. Priscilla also worked as a school nurse for many years at West Hartford Public Schools, Conard, Whiting Lane, Rayburn, and Bugby until her retirement. Students remember her as a calm and reassuring presence in their school. She was an involved parent and an active community member and volunteer. Her example of love, dedication, and compassionate care is her legacy. This award in her honor goes to Conard seniors who exemplify these qualities and who will pursue a career in nursing. Congratulations to Trisha DeRue and Jayant Karaturi, this year's recipients of the Librarians Appreciation Award, given to seniors who have made a positive contribution to the library environment, have shown an interest in discovering and exploring information resources, and it's demonstrated the kind of curiosity that turns students into lifelong learners. Congratulations to Evan Gordon, this year's recipient of the Officer John Luby PTO certificate. Officer John Luby, a community relations officer for the West Hartford Police Department, was well known and well liked by students and staff in all the town schools as he presented programs to all ages on safety issues. This award, in his honor, goes to a student who exemplifies those qualities reflected and taught by Officer Luby, which include being loyal, friendly, innovative, sensitive, and caring. Congratulations to Rose McGowan, this year's recipient of the Peter Luke Humanitarian Award. Peter Luke was a graduate of the Conard class of 1994. This award, in his honor, goes to a student who shows respect for fellow students and for diversity in human beings. Congratulations to Bryn Murphy, this year's recipient of the Gloria A. Maloney Scholarship Award. Gloria Maloney was a dedicated West Hartford Public School nurse and central nurse for 19 years. Her seven children and 13 of her 21 grandchildren will graduate from Conard High, the last two in 2023. This award, which her children established in her honor on her 80th birthday, goes to a senior with a love of learning who is caring and compassionate, especially with children, is a good friend to others, and who plans to pursue a career in the healthcare professions with preference given to a career in nursing. Congratulations to Ryan Lafferty, this year's recipient of the Dr. David Manning Award. Dr. David Manning, during his tenure as teacher and administrator at Conard, brought to his profession integrity, good humor, a love of history, and devotion to the school community. This award, in his honor, goes to a senior who has had a positive influence on fellow students, works to her or his full academic potential, demonstrates a love of history, and exemplifies the best of Conard. Ryan, you can circle back around. Congratulations again to Ryan Lafferty, this year's recipients of the Sam Martin Memorial Award. Sam Martin was a longtime English teacher at Conard who exemplified the highest degree of scholarship, learning, and compassion. This award in his honor goes to a senior who has shown the highest degree of scholarship and dedication to learning in her or his 4 years at Conard. Congratulations to Purit Butsapak and Tejal Nair, this year's recipients of the Mathematics Department PTO Award, given to outstanding seniors who show all-around performance in mathematics. Congratulations to Jude Sargent, this year's recipient of the Lieutenant Colonel Michael McMahon Memorial Award. Lieutenant Colonel Michael McMahon, Conard Class of 1981 and West Point Class of 1985, was a talented athlete, exemplary leader, devoted family man, and involved community member. He possessed these qualities throughout his life, including during his years at Conard. He was a career Army officer and helicopter pilot who died in a plane crash in Afghanistan in 2004 while serving his country. This award in his honor goes to a senior who exemplifies the traits that Lieutenant Colonel McMahon valued in his life and work, which includes strong leadership and athletic abilities, strong character and a positive attitude, integrity, academic achievement, reputation for friendliness and compassion toward others, and active involvement in Conard in the community. Along with you, the following students, please join us on stage: Charles Arnold and Shivani Brown. Today we offer special recognition to a select few individuals who have made a commitment to service to our country within the armed forces. The call to service is answered by less than 1% of the population. By answering this call, these students are setting themselves on a path to learn leadership and sacrifice, to earn loyalty and respect, to demonstrate honor and personal courage, and to dedicate themselves to duty and selfless service. Within their oath of enlistment, they take up the charge to defend our freedoms and our way of life against all threats, both foreign and domestic. By way of this choice, they have distinguished themselves among their peers and bring great credit upon themselves, their families, and our West Hartford community. Charles and Shivani will be enlisting in the United States Air Force, and Jude will be attending the United States Coast Guard Academy. Congratulations to Natalie Dela Cruz, this year's recipient of the Douglas J. Myers Scholarship Award. Douglas J. Myers, a member of Conard's class of 2002, taught those around him to cherish friendships and value life and what each of us may bring to this life. His resolve and courage in his battle with cancer that ended his life at the completion of his junior year was remarkable. This award in his honor goes to a senior who has demonstrated compassion towards others, a high caliber of citizenship through participation in either the Conard High community and or the town of West Hartford community, humility, a love of the outdoors, and is a team player. Congratulations to Emma Kramer and Allison Polyuk, this year's recipients of the National Band Award, given to two seniors that have demonstrated continued dedication and leadership in band. Congratulations to Lindy Quach, this year's recipient of the National Center for Women and Information Technology Aspirations and Computing Award, national recipient, given to high school women for their demonstrated interest and achievements in computing, proven leadership ability, academic performance, and plans for post-secondary education. Congratulations to Gabriella Jaloff, this year's recipient of the National Center for Women in Information Technology Aspirations and Computing Award, honorable mention, given to high school women for their demonstrated interest and achievements in computing, proven leadership ability, academic performance, and plans for post-secondary education. Congratulations to Rebecca Fleischman, Alexandra Hudson, and Tejal Nair, this year's recipients of the National Center for Women and Information Technology Aspirations and Computing Award, state winner, given to high school women who are active and interested in computing and technology with technical skills and or potential. Congratulations to Amanda Sagers, this year's recipient of the National Center for Women in Information Technology Aspirations and Computing Award, Rising Star, given to high school women who are active and interested in computing and technology with technical skills and or potential. Please welcome to the stage Assistant Principal Mr. Jamal Hines.
Congratulations to Nathan Sousa and Luke Yenesey, this year's recipients of the National Choral Award, given to two seniors that have demonstrated continued dedication and leadership in choir. Congratulations to Tolu Adatola, Ethan Matier, Ariana Roach, and Alexa Wells, for being selected as this year's 2021 National African American Recognition Program recipients. In order to qualify for this honor, a student must take the PSAT, NMSQT in October of junior year, be African American, achieve the minimum required score on the PSAT, NMSQT, and earn a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or higher by the middle of junior year. Congratulations. Congratulations to Matthew Hook and Cesar Santos for being selected as this year's 2021 National Hispanic Recognition Program recipient. In order to qualify for this honor, a student must take the PSAT, NMSQT in October of junior year, be at least one quarter Hispanic or Latino, achieve the minimum required score on the PSAT or the NMSQT, and earn a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or higher by the middle of junior year. The National Merit Scholarship Program is an academic competition for recognition and scholarships. High school students earn the National Merit Program by taking the preliminary SAT or National Merit Scholarship qualifying test and by meeting published program entry and participation requirements. The following students receive recognition on their basis of their scores. Congratulations to Benjamin Covici, Rebecca Fleischman, and Charles Kreisch for being selected as this year's Commended Students 2021 National Merit Scholarship Program, which goes to students who took the PSAT, NMSQT in October of their junior year and were among the top 50,000 scores of the tests. Congratulations to Parit Butsapek, Ryan Lafferty, and Rashiel Yarabelli for being named as 2021 National Merit Scholarship Program finalists. Goes to students who took the PSAT, NMSQT in October of their junior year and were among the top 15,000 scorers of the tests. Congratulations. Congratulations to Elizabeth Lamarco and Ariana Roach, this year's recipients of the National Orchestra Award, to two seniors that have demonstrated continued dedication and leadership in orchestra. Congratulations. Congratulations to Haley Weissman, this year's recipient of the Francis and Nathan Navarre Memorial Scholarship. It goes to a senior who demonstrates a passion for community service and leadership abilities and will be pursuing their education in the field of nursing or criminal justice. Congratulations. Congratulations to Tejel Nair and Mia Olson, this year's recipients of the Orchestra PTO Award, which goes to students who demonstrate strong leadership skills, dedication to music making, and is a positive presence in and out of the classroom. Congratulations. Congratulations to Jesse Amchok and Bridget Drummy, this year's recipients of the Outstanding High School Accounting Student Award, which goes to outstanding accounting students with a sincere interest in a future career in accounting. Congratulations. Congratulations to Randy Figueroa Acevedo and Jasmine Maldonado, this year's recipients of the Overall Academic Improvement PTO Award, which goes to outstanding students based on all-around performance who have overcome difficulties or obstacles. Congratulations. Congratulations to Ryan Roller, this year's recipient of the Carl P. Palazzotto PMA Scholarship Award. Carl Palazzotto taught for 23 years and coached cross country and track for 14 years in the West Hartford Public Schools. He was renowned for his PMA, positive mental attitude philosophy, and directing his athletes. This award, in his honor, goes to a senior student athlete who consistently exhibits a positive mental attitude and demonstrates the ability to inspire PMA and other students, has a track record of athletic and academic success, and best exemplifies the qualities that Coach P demonstrated in his daily life. Preference may be given to students who participate in cross country and or track. Congratulations. Congratulations to Alexa Wells, this year recipient of the Mary Ann Papa Award. Mary Ann Papa began work in the West Hartford Public Schools in 1965 as a mathematics teacher and continued until 2000 when she retired from Conard as mathematics department supervisor and BC calculus teacher. Her legacy is one of dedication to students and staff, enthusiasm for learning, and commitment to excellence. This award in her honor goes to a senior with a GPA of 3.5 or higher who excels in math, but also displays interest in other disciplines, exhibits a genuine interest in learning, displays a sincere concern for peers, and contributes to the classroom environment through good citizenship. Congratulations. Congratulations to Tolo Adetola, this year's recipient of the Braden Farrell Award. The Braden Farrell Award is given to an outstanding African-American college-bound senior who demonstrates strong leadership potential, academic curiosity, and a dedication to community service. Congratulations. Congratulations to Isabel Burnett Herkes and Cesar Santos, this year's recipients of the Physical Education Department PTO Award, which goes to two outstanding seniors based on their great effort and achievement in physical education and for their many contributions to make such a positive difference to all those around them. Congratulations. Congratulations to Marlena Bailey, Isabella Balta, Aaron Borla, Emery Budak, Rachel Burtness, Erica Kangro, Mary Capone, Courtney Chamberlain, Mara Fletcher, Julia Kearney, Ella Kimberly, Maxwell Langwa, Margaret Leonard, Eloise McKinnon, Owen McGoldrick, Diana McGovern, Maggie Michkowski, Audrey Mongolo, Zoe Morrow, Catherine Wynn, Chloe Nole, Connor Olechna, Bloxon Pardell, Angela Pham, Romy Reichenberg, Allison Shane, Emma Simpson, Kayla Usman, this year's recipients of the Principal's Scholar Award, which goes to seniors for academic achievement in challenging programs of studies with significant extracurricular involvement, who is deserving of recognition. Congratulations to all of you. Congratulations to Chloe Starr, this year's recipient of the Rotary Club Award, which goes to a senior who best demonstrates the Rotary ideal of self-service above self to the school, to the community, and to the world. Congratulations. Congratulations to Austin Crossley, Lindy Quach, and Nick Ursa, this year's recipients of the Frank and Emmeline Scheel Memorial Scholarship Award, which goes to seniors with academic achievement and citizenship. Congratulations. Congratulations to Ryan Lafferty, this year's recipient of the Science Department PTO Award, which goes to an outstanding senior who shows all-around performance in science. Congratulations. Congratulations to Austin Crossley and Avery Placida, this year's recipients of the Adam Smith Book Award, to AP Economic students who passionately delve into the many facets of economics while performing at a very high level in the course. Congratulations. Congratulations to Natalie Dela Cruz, this year's recipient of the Social Studies Citizenship Service Award, which goes to a senior who exemplifies the ideal of public service to the local community through volunteer activities. Congratulations. Congratulations to Allison Pauluk and Rachelle Yarabelli, this year's recipients of the Social Studies Department PTO Award, which goes to outstanding students who show all-around performance in social studies. Congratulations. Congratulations to Christina Coburn, this year's recipient of the Spanish Teachers Award, which goes to a junior or senior for whom Spanish is not her or his first language, who has shown an extraordinary interest in and enthusiasm for learning Spanish, has achieved strong language skills, particularly speaking, and who has also shown a genuine interest in Spanish culture by making it a part of his or her everyday life. Congratulations. Congratulations to Jason Lau, this year's recipient of the Student Recognition Award, which goes to a student who has maintained a positive attitude, achieved academically to his or her best capability, and demonstrated involvement in school and community. Congratulations. Congratulations to Josh Bodebo and Grace O'Rourke, this year's recipients of the Studio Art PTO Award, which goes to outstanding students based on all-around performance and studio art. Congratulations. Congratulations to Hallie Weissman, this year's recipient of the Francis Sullivan Award, which goes to a senior who demonstrates a clear grasp of personal goals and shows a singular dedication in pursuit of these goals. Congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations to Abigail Hughes and Hanif Jackson, this year's recipients of the Technology and Engineering Department PTO Award, which goes to outstanding senior students in technology education. Congratulations. Congratulations to Gabriel Harford Martinez, this year's recipient of the John P. Webster Library Alternative High School Book Award, which goes to a junior or senior at Reach who has grown positively both academically and personally. Congratulations. Congratulations to Mia Olson, this year's recipient of the West Hartford Administration Association Scholarship. The West Hartford Administration Association Scholarship is awarded to deserving students who are dedicated to pursuing a career in public education. Congratulations. Congratulations to Nora Wilson, this year's recipient of the West Hartford Community Theater Scholarship. West Hartford Community Theater is a nonprofit organization dedicated to the development of live theater in West Hartford and related educational programs for adults and children. Each year, a scholarship is awarded to a graduating senior with good academic performance who is committed to pursuing a theater arts major at a four-year college or university. Congratulations. Congratulations to Alyssa Martinez, this year's recipient of the West Hartford Scholarship Fund, which goes to a senior who demonstrates good citizenship and scholastic ability. Congratulations. Congratulations to Cesar Santos and Chloe Starr, this year's recipients of the Tracy Wilson Peace and Justice Award, which goes to seniors who have made significant contributions to building understanding among different peoples and who has furthered the cause of social justice. Congratulations. Congratulations to Rebecca Fleischman, this year's recipient of the Women in Science and Engineering Scholarship, which goes to a female member of the senior class who is dedicated to pursuing a major in science and engineering at a four-year college or university and has demonstrated strong academic achievement throughout her 4 years at Conard. Congratulations. Congratulations to Stephanie Rooney Shearer, this year's recipient of the Woodfield Family Choral Award. Cross Conard class of 2002, Ashley, 2005, and Colby of 2009, all have the privilege of participating in Conard's Choirs and Honors program. Their family believes it is this participation that complemented their efforts in the classroom and most benefited them in their extracurricular activities. Their commitment to all aspects of singing and performing provided much joy and ultimately gave them confidence to succeed in other endeavors. It is with gratitude that their parents present this award to a choral student who has shown exceptional devotion and a tireless work ethic to Conard's choral program. Congratulations. And congratulations to Hallie Weissman and Rachelle Yarabelli, this year's recipients of the World Language Department PTO Award, which goes to outstanding senior student in world language. Congratulations.
On behalf of the entire Conard family, we one more time will applaud all of your amazing accomplishments. I would also like to give a quick thank you, a quick special thank you to Ms. Hickey, Ms. Blair, and Mr. Horton for all of their help organizing today's event. We give them a round of applause. On your way out, please remember to grab one of the programs. You may not want it, but trust me, someone at home is going to want it. So please grab it for them and bring it home. Again, congratulations and have a wonderful night. Thank you.